Hi, everyone. It's 10:35. We're running a little bit late because of some cars. Oh, no, you guys can talk. I'm just letting everyone viewing on Facebook. We're going to be on in, I'm going to say about 3 or 4 minutes. So if you're watching live, 3 or 4 minutes, and you'll see everyone coming here. We'll see you in a couple minutes. Thanks. Well, now you guys aren't even in my field of vision for talking.
You just turned it.
Yeah, so I think, is everyone? Yeah, so Abby and Rick will have you kind of come right here at the far end. You'll be, that way you'll be in the shade 6 feet. That will be 6 feet.
Hi, Abby.
So technically, if anyone is part of their bubble of 10, do you guys know what the bubble of 10 is?
Yes.
Okay, so if anyone's part of a bubble of 10 with someone here, you can actually sit much closer. So, I don't know if anyone here is.
Well, we got Ron and Al about Ron
a bubble.
I was sitting on a tailgate.
Oh, okay.
So, tailgate party.
Yeah, right?
Well, none of us got tailgate.
All right. Yeah, just open that up, hon, and then we'll have the rest of the people pull through and just back in if they show up late. Yeah, it's 10:35.
Yeah. Hans is usually last and he's here.
Yeah.
We're okay.
I'm like, I know. So this is the first, I'll come over here. So that way the people who are online can see me. So I'll be looking over here for those of you online because everyone's sitting in the shade because it is like super hot. But, so
turn
I
your mic on.
Oh, thanks. That's a great idea. There we go. Can you guys hear me? Can you hear me?
No.
My mic's on.
Turn the speaker a bit this way.
All right, hon, can you?
I got
to.
Oh no, right. That's good.
Yeah, so you can hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. So I want to thank everyone for coming out today. I did not plan this, but this is actually 4 months since I preached my first sermon here at Newington. So I didn't plan it like that. Palm Sunday was the 4th or was the 5th of April, and so today is. So what a great way to celebrate 4 months here at Newington, being able to gather together. And so just a few instructions. If you have to use the bathroom, you can use the church bathrooms. However, you have to go one at a time. Yeah. So you have to go one at a time. And there is hand sanitizer in there for you to use afterwards, but there's also Clorox wipes, and so we ask that you just wipe down the handle and the seat and the wash handle with the Clorox wipe when you're done and then throw it away. That way we can keep it clean for everyone. There are two bathrooms, but again, just one at a time. And so without any further ado, we are going to have some singing songs led by Linda and Olivia. We don't have music for you, unfortunately, like handouts, so hopefully you guys will know all these songs. So I'll take the
lead.
I almost died. It's okay. I've been here 4 months.
Seems it might have been a short 4 months after all that.
My mouth will I make known.
We invite you to sing along. You know these songs. You may not have the words in front of you, but I'm sure you can pick up some of the words. We're doing Change My Heart, O God, now.
Okay, can you hear me? You can? I do this every single time I'm with Mike. But so anyways, I asked everyone to bring their food so we could kind of have a meal together. I don't know, everyone's here in the shade, if you have that, but if you want to start eating now, I know it's a little early for lunch. No one has lunch at 10:30?
No.
No? It's 10:45. That's even better for lunch. But if any of you brought food that you want to eat right now, obviously we can't have potlucks. We can't have stuff like that. I don't know why I'm... obviously we can't have potlucks and things like that. It's my... Yeah. There we go. Wow. Okay. but obviously we can enjoy food together at the same time, and so I just want to pray a blessing over food. If any of you want to eat food or are eating food at home, because I know we have people who are at home watching, I just wanted to pray a blessing over the food. And then afterwards we are going to have Marylin come up and read a passage of scripture. So all right, let's pray for food. Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. We thank you that we are able to gather together, even though it's not necessarily how we normally worship, Lord. We are so thankful after 4 months of not being able to gather together that now here we are able to worship you, able to enjoy a time of fellowship. And we just give thanks for the beautiful weather you've been giving us, for the rain, which, you know, came quickly last night and is gone, Lord, but just for the nice cool breeze that we have here in the sun and the shade. And we pray that you will continue to bless us, bless those of us who are having a meal right now, the food, that it will nourish us, and that we will be able to continue to bring you glory. We pray this in Jesus Christ's powerful name. Amen.
About you, but although I couldn't really hear the voices around me, there was something very special about being here and not singing in front of my TV. Are you with me? Yes. We couldn't really hear one another, but it's a little bit more like worshiping together, I'd say. And I'm just full of thanksgiving and praise. And this morning is a morning set aside for just that, our thanksgiving and praise. And I want to read Psalm 8 at this time. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. From the lips of children and infants, you have ordained praise because of your enemies, to silence the foe and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have set in place, what is man that you are mindful of him, the son of man that you care for him? You made him a little lower than the heavenly beings and crowned him with glory and honor. You made him ruler over the works of your hands. You put everything under his feet, all flocks and herds, and the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, and the fish of the sea, all that swim the paths of the sea. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. And the people said, Amen, Amen.
All right. Thank you, Marylin, for reading that. It's nice not to just have a recording of someone reading with the words up, but to actually see them. I'm super excited at this time. Abby is going to come forward, and she's going to share a little bit about the children's ministry that's going to be happening and what we're going to be doing in the fall. So, Abby, super, super excited for you, and I'm just going to do this because this is what the government says we need to do.
Everything's 100% now because it was wiped out.
Good morning, guys. Can you hear me okay? Okay.
Closer.
Closer, like that? Okay. So, good morning. It is super nice to see your actual faces. It is so nice. So, I'm here to talk for a moment about children's ministry for the upcoming year. As I guess what I would call probably just the lead teacher, I have already chosen from a website. Is it newspring.com?
Yes.
Okay. If you want to peek there because you're curious like I am, you can go to newspring.com and you can see these lesson plans. But what I've selected for the goal time is around mid-September. is what Pastor Dave has asked me to plan for. I've chosen a series of 8 lessons, actually, that I'm going to cut short for a happy reason. I'll tell you in a moment. called Way Out West. And what that series does is really brings to the children basic things that I think we would agree that we want them to know, that God loves them, that they can talk to God, that they can trust God, and that he really listens, and he is their helper. Agreed?
Amen.
All right. Now, the reason it may get cut short from 8 lessons is that there are 5 lessons that I really am excited to do around Christmas time, of course. I love Christmas. So that series is called Holly Jolly Kitchen. So if you get onto newspring.com, again, the first series is going to be Way Out West. The next series is going to be Holly Jolly Kitchen. I want to say Christmas. That's why I'm hesitating. So it's Holly Jolly Kitchen. And so if we have to cut the 8 short just to fit in all those wonderful Christmas lessons, we'll do that. This year is only a hair of a change. Pastor Dave is encouraging us to work in partnerships rather than singletons. So we will hopefully work in pairs of teachers for 3 Sundays out of the month. And then Potluck Sunday, we will not have a children's specific lesson, but rather the actual time we spend upstairs will be geared a bit toward the kids as well, a little more than average. Alrighty. So if you're interested in being in one of the partnerships, the partnerships are not fully formed yet, although we're getting there. Alrighty. And if you have any questions, of course, email me or call me. It's always easier to email me because I teach online, and so I'm usually face-to-face with a student down in New York City, believe it or not. So I can access the emails faster and respond to you faster that way if you have a question.
We didn't think that far through.
All right. There we go. All right. I'm super excited about the children's ministry starting up. I know it's something that, for those of you who have attended Newington for a while, it's something that I was always told about VBS and everything and how exciting that was. And so I'm super excited for Abby kind of taking charge and being willing to lead that and working with her through the different things to have that. At this time, Olivia is going to come, and we were going to share a little bit about the missions, the different missions that we support. But literally every email or update that I got was basically, we're doing okay, but COVID is happening. So instead of an update, which there really wasn't much that I had received via email and things like that, instead, she's going to pray for our missionaries. And she's gonna spend some time praying for them, as well as praying for a few of the church plants in the area not far from us who were deeply affected by COVID. But thankfully, and this is a huge prayer request, Parkway Church Plant, which is led by Pastor Dusty. I don't know if many of you know him, but he used to be the youth pastor in Brockville. Is it Brockville? Roblin. Roblin, thank you. Used to be the youth pastor in Roblin. Started this church, and for their 1-year anniversary, COVID happened. And they had to close down, and during that time, they got 600 people, 600 different people watching their service. And they were a church probably about 70 or 80 at that time, meeting in a school. And they were one of the first Wesleyan churches, one of the first churches in their area, but also one of the first Wesleyan churches to go on. And they had over 600 people, and have continually had over 400 people watching their services. And so that's a huge praise, because that's a largely unchurched area that God is using them. And so she's going to be praying for them and the other church plants as well.
Hard to play guitar and hold a mic after holding him. So I'd like to invite us all to join in prayer this morning, and if you know some of the individuals and ministries that we support, please feel free to just pray out as we pray together, okay? Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning in just so much joy and so much thankfulness that we can gather together, even if we are apart. And so, Lord, for these things, we say thank you. Lord, we come before you not only on behalf of our own joy and our own needs, but for the needs of those who you have called us to support around the world. Lord, for our missionaries who are working with global partners, hear our prayer. Lift them up, protect them, care for them, give them the resources that they need in this time. We know, Lord, that there are things that are happening in their ministries where they're okay, they're just getting by, but Lord, we want your kingdom to flourish. And so, Lord, we pray that you would enable them to find ways to minister, to find ways to support one another, and ways to stay safe through all of this. Lord, for the ministries that we support through World Hope, hear our prayer. We pray that each one of them, from the Ukraine to all other places around the world, you would be present. That regardless of what type of ministry, it would be one that your presence would be seen, even though things look different. Lord, we pray for those who are being pulled from situations of human trafficking and being brought into new lives, that they would be healthy and safe and protected by the work that your kingdom is doing. And so, Lord, we pray that your kingdom would be built up. We pray for our church plants, Lord. We talk about missions overseas, and Lord, we also want to focus our attention here a little bit as well. There are those who have just started to come to know you, and their only opportunity to do that has been closed. And so, Lord, we pray for the diligence of church planters, from Dusty to Nathan to each of our other church planters and church replants like Slave Lake. Lord, we just want to thank you that you are present in each of these situations. We pray for Pastor Luis and Anna. We pray that the churches who are just getting off the ground, Lord, you would be present in their midst. We pray that whatever online presence they're able to offer, you would speak through it. And people sitting at home on their couches, even though it's hard not to hear one another singing, would be able to feel the presence of your Holy Spirit. Lord, we pray these things, knowing that you are a God who hears us and who is always with us and is always invested in our very best interest. And so, Lord, we lift these things up to you. In the name of the Father, and of the Holy Spirit, and of the Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Marylin, first song.
Again, listen to the word of the Lord. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord Almighty. My soul yearns, even faints for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. Even the sparrow has found a home and the swallow a nest for herself, where she may have her young. A place near your altar. O Lord Almighty, my King and my God. Blessed are those who dwell in your house. They are ever praising you. Blessed are those whose strength is in you, who have set their hearts on pilgrimage. As they pass through the valley of Baca, may it be a place of springs. The autumn rains also cover it with pools. They go from strength to strength, till each appears before God in Zion. Hear my prayer, O Lord God Almighty, listen to me, O God of Jacob. Look upon our shield, O God. Look with favor on your anointed one. Better is one day in your courts than a thousand elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of the wicked. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord bestows favor and honor. No good thing will he withhold from those whose walk is blameless. O Lord Almighty, blessed is the man who trusts in you. Gracious Heavenly Father, we are grateful this morning that we can gather in this place. And truly, this is your sanctuary. This is your creation. This is the place of your dwelling. Because you dwell in the hearts of each of us. Lord, we thank you for the way you have kept us over these last months. We thank you for the way that you have continued to bring the ministry of Newington Wesleyan Church, not only to each of us, but to others who have tuned in. Your kingdom has continued to grow and to flourish, not in spite of, but because you are the God who is in control. We give you praise. Lord, I thank you for each one who's gathered here. But Lord, we also want to lift those who have not, for various reasons, felt that they could be here this morning. We pray your blessing upon them. We pray your blessing upon those who are watching online. We are your people. We are your church. And Lord, my prayer is that you would continue to be glorified, that the presence of Newington Wesleyan in this community and in its broader surroundings would continue to have an impact, that we would be a light, if not on a hill, at least on the highway, showing the way to you. And as we continue in this time together, noting the things that you have been accomplishing, I pray that you would receive our praise and our thanksgiving. And we pray all this in the precious and holy name of our Lord Jesus Christ with thanksgiving. Amen.
All right. Well, no, I'm not really warm. It's kind of nice out with the breeze and standing in the shade. So I do need to be over here though. So glad again that we're able to gather together. I will be honest. One of the reasons that I wanted us to be able to gather together today is so that we could talk a little bit about the direction and the vision of the church. Specifically, looking at this coming fall, looking at 2020 and how things are going to unfold. Because the reality is as much as we desire for church to go back the same old way that it always has. It's going to be different, and it's going to look different, but something that I truly believe deep down and that Olivia believes is that Newington is here for a reason. We believe it's not a coincidence that where many of the other churches in Newington closed down and a lot of the other churches in the area, we believe that Newington was open for a reason. We believe that in the midst of searching for a pastor for over 6 months, almost a year, that it stayed open, that it stayed strong, that people stayed engaged in their faith. And we believe that that wasn't just happenstance, that God has a plan for Newington. And because we believe that, I felt that, you know, just going on and kind of carrying on as if nothing had changed, as if, you know, there wasn't, if I wasn't here, you know, if there wasn't a leadership team here, I kind of felt that that would be doing a little bit of an injustice. I felt that in the midst of everything, we still need to strive to reach Newington. We still need to strive to reach the 20 kilometers bubble sphere that there is where there's not a lot of evangelical churches. And so one of the things I kind of wanted to just talk about, and one of the things we kind of have to decide as a church, is if we want to move forward in that way. And what it really comes down to is how is it that we want to spend the resources that God has given us. And there was posted on our website, as well as we have some handout copies of what I have proposed as the spending plan for the 2020-2021 year. And it's a little bit different. So the Wesleyan Church, I just want to explain the difference between a budget and a spending plan. A lot of churches are used to saying budget. This is our budget. This is what we're going to do. A few years ago, I think it was about 5 or 6 years ago, the Wesleyan Church encouraged churches to go from a budget to a spending plan. And the reason is a budget, this is the allocated money. So if we say we're going to spend $500 in worship, or, you know, we're going to spend $300 in guest speakers, then if something comes up according to a budget, the whole church and the leadership would have to vote to move money from one section to another. So if all of a sudden we needed an extra $100 and we had $100 in our budget in public speaking or in having guest speakers, but nowhere else, we would have to all vote and everything would have to be approved in order for that to happen. Where a spending plan says this is the suggested area. We're going to have this much of an income we're suggesting, and this is where we're suggesting we're going to spend it. But if for some reason the leadership team, the LBA, myself, and the leaders of ministry realize, hey, we're not spending money here, how about we move it to somewhere where we need that extra money, we don't have to go for a whole entire church vote in order to do that. And so for legal reasons and for tax reasons, they said, hey, let's have churches switch to a spending plan. It's a little bit easier. It's a lot less messy if a tragedy or something happens to where you have to move funds around. And so I put forward a spending plan. And my spending plan, which was in my pocket, has gone missing. Here it is. And so the spending plan I put forward and that I showed was broken up into three different things. And what I wanted to do was to show you guys what the year before, before we were here, what you had suggested. So this was our suggested budget. And then I wanted to show you the actual budget that Newington had spent. And then the third column was what I am suggesting. And then the last column, as I explained on the PDF, shows what the difference is, whether we're saving money or whether we're spending more money in each different area. And the idea was in some areas we're going to save money, and in some areas we're going to spend a little bit more. The spot where you're going to be spending the most money is the fact that you're paying a senior pastor this year. And last year, that money was not spent. In fact, it was saved. And we still have a majority of those funds in the savings at the church. So we actually have some extra money there. And so in kind of looking at and walking around Newington, these papers just don't want to behave. In walking around Newington and in looking in my few months here, I kind of saw that there are a lot of kids. Like there's a lot of families, there's a lot of young families, there's a lot of couples that have moved in here. And my heart just really felt that with such a great VBS program, with so many kids here, why don't we try to minister to the family? Why don't we try to be a church that ministers and focuses on strengthening families? You know, a lot of churches say, hey, we're going to be a family church. We're all about families. But the thing is, it really shows in what programs and what is the church offering to help those families, right? You can say, hey, we really believe in families, but not offer one single, you know, sermon or one single life group or anything that helps strengthen a family. In New York State, they have a channel, and I don't know if you can pick it up here, but it's called Focus on the Family. Do they have that up here? It's a radio program called Focus on the Family. And everything that they do, the different things that they have, are how can we strengthen people? How can we strengthen families by helping them overcome addictions? How can we strengthen them by diving deeper as men of God? How can we help them by diving deeper and becoming godly women? And so when I thought about that and I came to the spending plan, I said, you know, we really need to have resources. So if we say we want to be a church that is going to focus on families, that the potential to spend those funds is there. Again, it doesn't mean we have to spend it. It just means that the potential is there. And so in the spending plan that I put forward, before, you'll notice in all of the previous years, you guys had a Christian education fund. And it was just Christian education. And it was whatever came in, that was what we had to spend on Christian education. What I did this year was I said, let's take Christian education and actually break it down into the categories that would help families grow. Let's break it down into the areas that said, you know what, if we want to be a church that is going to help minister to families, be it people who are single, be it people who, you know, are new couples, be it people who have been married for years but still want to continue to grow in godliness, how is it that we can do that? And so I said, if we take Christian education and we actually break that down, and instead of saying whatever comes in for Christian education we're going to spend, but instead said, you know what, we're going to value people growing in Christ, we're going to value families growing in Christ, if we actually put that in part of our budget, what would that look like? And so most of the church is the same as far as the budget and the spending. The biggest change comes in the Christian education and outreach section. And so what I proposed in the spending plan is that we would have up to $2,000 to spend in children's ministry. That would include a VBS program, an online VBS program, which I'm working with Abby to have towards the end of August. That would include having an online platform for children's ministry, which I'm excited. For those of you who watched the sermon earlier today, you know I announced that we're going to actually be having lessons and things like that online. That would include paying for crafts and things like that, so that way it's not just coming out of the church's pocket. That would include basically anything children's ministry. Also, the potential for a youth ministry. Now, I don't know if that's something that would really go over well here, but being a youth pastor for 10 years, I've started 4 different youth groups, and so I know how to do that. So if that's something that ends up being here, I wanted to just at least have the potential for funds there. Includes having funds for life groups, which has been the main way that a lot of you have been connecting over Zoom, and we're going to have the life group that's going to be starting here Monday night, tomorrow night. That's going to be starting here on dialogues and having conversations. It includes Sunday school material, children's outreach, and adult outreach. And so those are kind of the major differences for the spending plan. The problem is that as of right now, what the church is bringing in is not enough even to cover our basic expenses. So if we were to strip everything down and were to say, hey, we're not going to do anything other than just pay our bills and everything, the church is still at a little bit of a deficit. So by doing this, we would be saying and we would be trusting that in 2 years' time, in 2 years, because that's how much we have saved up, we have 2 years of extra money basically saved up, we would be saying in 2 years' time, we believe that by being faithful to the Lord and by saying we're going to grow in these areas, that God will bless us, that God will reward those efforts, and we will make up the deficit that we would currently be spending. And so the difference is, if we went bare bones and we said we're not going to do any ministries, we would have 4 years' worth of extra funds So this is saying we're going to have two extra years. And so what basically, because this is something that needs to be voted on and decided, is we have to decide as a church if this is the direction we want to go, or if it's something that you're like, you know what, we need to rethink this. And so part of the reason I wanted to meet today was, one, to share my heart that I believe Newington is here, and I believe that by focusing on family ministries and helping families grow, we can make an impact in this area. I just drove out to Avonmore yesterday to pick up berries, and my heart just broke. Like, I have not been outside of Newington other than Cornwall and Marylin's house. That's it. That's the extent that I knew of the area where God has called us to come minister. But when I went there, I just felt my heart breaking. I felt my heart breaking that there were two churches that had small parking lots that basically, as far as I could tell, looked closed. My heart was broken because I saw these houses, large farmlands, and I wondered, do these people even know who Christ is? And I just felt that Newington could be a part, whether it's us connecting people to a church where they can worship better, whether it's them deciding to worship here, if it's just them hearing the gospel, you know, in a way that's relevant. I just felt in my heart that this is what Newington could do. This is the ministry Newington could have. And so I want to open up right now for questions, for comments, concerns, anything like that, because obviously you're putting a lot of trust into a guy that you're only seeing for the second time in person. but this is a spending plan that the LBA, that those who have called Newington their home for a while, felt was a good course of action. And so it is with their blessing. I'm not just pulling this out of thin air. We discussed it. We talked about it. But I do want to allow this time for questions, for concerns, or any kind of statement from those of you that are here. If you're online, I'll try to see if something pops up, but mostly for those of you who are here. So what I'm asking is, if you guys are okay with it, that's good. This is my first time leading a meeting like this. what I'm asking is, we are going to move forward with this budget. Thank you, Al. we're gonna move forward. If you should decide to move forward with this budget, with this spending plan. Sorry, see, I used the wrong word. With this spending plan, which means that we would have 2 years to bring in the income that would be needed to make up us using the funds that we have saved up right now. And so I'm asking for the approval of those of you who are here, based on the recommendation of the LBA and looking over the finances myself, if you guys want to move forward with that spending plan. And so if there's any questions or concerns about that, or just comments, now would be the time to voice those before we somewhat vote, because technically at this year we're just supposed to move forward with our old spending plan. I'm kind of being a rebel and saying, let's move forward with Newington growing, let's move forward with the gospel proceeding forward and do something crazy. That's kind of the guy I am. So if there's any comments, concerns, questions, now would be the time to, I would love to hear them.
If you need somebody to start, I'm with you.
Al?
I think that's a sound plan, because we have to do something different. If we keep going the way we are, everybody gets older and we'll die one by one, and then, you know, there won't be a church. So I think that trying to reach families is a wonderful thing, because we need families here. We need children here. We need younger people here. And I think it's a great idea.
Right. And so Al just shared, for those of you on, that he felt that it was a good idea, that reaching families. And so is there any other... Oh, that wasn't thunder. Are there any other questions? Anyone a comment? Yes.
I don't disagree with your plan, but I think we should see more of it. In other words, you said it was on the website?
Yes. I have physical copies if you would like to look over a physical copy of it. Yeah.
I think we should have time to review this plan before voting on it.
I agree. Olivia, the 19th? Okay, I'm going to get, so I have physical copies. It is online for those of you who are able to see it. But what we can do, we are opening on the 19th. And so we could vote on the 19th. That would be 2 weeks to be able to look over it and to consider it.
You mean the church is opening on the 19th?
Yes, yes. That you just skipped. That was going to be announced at the end. But so we could do it on the 19th. If that would be 2 weeks. That's kind of the standard amount of time for looking over something like this. And obviously adjustments can always be made in a spending plan. That's the nice thing. Adjustments can be made in that. So
you have I don't have a computer.
So we have physical copies. Yes, I have 10 physical copies here with me. We can always make more if need be, or email them.
I have a question, not a...
Okay, a question?
2 years that we're going to try this plan, how much extra money do we have to bring in order to continue?
So 2 years, so this year, continuing with this plan and saying next year we don't increase anything, we would need to bring in an extra $11,000, which just to put it, I don't tend to like to do this, but that would mean we would have to have between 4 and 5 new people coming to the church who are tithing regularly. So a way to put it in terms of like people who are involved in the church, if we had 4 or 5 families come and they were tithing partially or fully or something like that, that would be the growth we would need in order to see that made up. Good question. And I realize I didn't state the question. The question was how much would need to be brought in order to make up the money we're spending. Oh, that's a great question. So this is a little bit about me. Both Olivia and I studied, and we chose to be Wesleyan. So we looked at all the different denominations. We looked at non-denominational, and we said, if we're going to become pastors, where do we want to serve? And we very adamantly decided, because of the theology and because of everything of the Wesleyan Church, that we wanted to be Wesleyan. So this would not be a move to being a community church. It would be a move towards looking at the sermons we're preaching, looking at the life groups we're leading, looking at the programs that we're doing, and saying, how can we gear these so that way anyone, whether you're single, whether you're a small family, whether you're can grow in their faith and grow as a family. And so whether it's single and learning, hey, how do I treat people, or how do I date as a Christian, or whatever it is, it would be leaning towards that. So no, it wouldn't be moving towards a community church. It would be moving towards how do we make it so families and individuals can grow in holiness. Yeah, bringing people together and the relationship and helping them have better relationships would be the main focus.
But we would be more than welcoming any denomination to come and call this their home church. So yes, we're open to, you know, any churches that are closing, whether it be United or Catholic or wherever background you have, we want to be open to be able to accept them. But we won't.
Yeah.
Things are working together.
Yeah. Something that was just shared off to the side was the fact that we do welcome anyone to come and worship. I very much have Wesleyan beliefs, Wesleyan theology that I've chosen. There are some non-essential things in theology that I tend to differ in, which I would love to talk to you if you want to know what they are. They're nothing really big. But Love to talk to people about that. But we welcome anyone. If they want to grow closer to Christ, they want to grow in holiness. And that's always been a very strong emphasis of John Wesley, of the Wesleyan Church, is growth in holiness and helping social justice. That has always been very Wesleyan. And that's what we were. But if someone wants to come from another church, they just have to understand, hey, I'm a Wesleyan. I'm going to preach Wesleyan theology. If you differ from that, as long as you believe in Jesus Christ, in unity, in the essentials, unity. That's an old thing. In the non-essentials, you can differ. But if someone's growing in Christ, if someone it says, here's where I want to worship, we would more than willing have them there. But as long as I'm here and as long as I'm allowed to preach, and I'm holding the mic right now, so I will hold to a Wesleyan, and more importantly, what I view as a biblical theology. Not saying other denominations aren't biblical, but I will stand with what first and foremost Scripture says, and I tend to lean towards a Wesleyan theology in that. So. Is there? All right. I understand it's getting warm. I don't know if it's because I'm in a jacket underneath a tent or if it's just getting warm outside. So we will be wrapping it up. What was kind of decided that I'm hearing through there is on the 19th, which here's the announcement, July 19th, we are going to be having church service again. Woo! Where? Here. In the building. That's right. So on July 19th, we are going to be holding services again. I know that when I talked a few weeks ago, I said there were different stages we wanted to see. First, we wanted to make sure we could keep everyone safe. We've relatively been able to do that. We do have a committee that is meeting this week that is going to look at how we can continue to keep people safe. The second thing is I said we wanted to be able to figure out online. This little doohickey right here and people who might be watching solves that problem. We're going to be able to be online. For those of you who desire to still stay at home because you, for whatever reason, whether you feel it's safer or it's just easier, you will be able to watch online at home. That was the second thing we said we wanted to be able to do. The third was that if people wanted to come, we would have enough room. According to Ontario guidelines, you can have 30% of your church capacity, which for us would be 37. We can currently, with the chairs that are in the sanctuary, fit 37 people. And so we are going to be setting up so that way everyone who desires to attend would be able to attend. And there's going to be more coming out with that around the 12th, the 13th, but that will be set up. That was the fourth thing that I said, or third thing, I can't count right now. That was the second to last thing I said we wanted to do. And then the last thing I said is we wanted to make sure we would have something that the children could engage with, that people, regardless of where they are in your family, would be able to engage with. And so we are working on that, obviously, with the children's ministry, where online they will have activities, they'll have lessons that they can just watch at home. And if you do not have internet access, or if you have internet access like the one we have at the church, we are also going to be working on putting it on a DVD, so that way you can just watch it on a DVD. So we're going to be working on that as well. I didn't tell Abby that, but don't worry, I'll help you with that, Abby. we're going to be working on that as well, so that way the children can engage, and when they come Sunday, they'll have an activity that they can engage that will follow up with what they've been learning during the week. And so those were the things that I had said earlier. We want to reach all of these before we reopen. And praise the Lord, through creativity, through larger churches, giving resources for free and doing that, we're going to be able to do that. And so I think we can give a big hallelujah for that.
Hallelujah!
Okay. Woo. Yeah. So on the 12th, we will be having church like we've been having. So it will be online. We might test out. I'm going to send an email out this week. We might test out running it live. That hasn't really been decided. But on the 19th is when people will be able to gather. And again, there are going to be emails sent out. There are going to be videos that will be posted. There are going to be however I can get it to you, I'm going to get it to you with the instructions of how that is going to work. Because we will be opening. Again, our goal is in September to be able to hopefully, when schools open, follow their regulations and have something for children's ministry. Again, we're going to have to watch and see how schools and things like that go about. But that is our goal. And so I am super excited to announce that. And at the end of the 19th, after you have been able to look over the spending plan a little bit more and ask any questions based on that, we will take a vote on the spending plan and, you know, hopefully, whether it's a yay or a nay, we will be able to continue in the direction that the Lord has been laying on our hearts and has been giving us. And so I'm going to invite Linda and my wife, my wife, there she is. I'm going to invite Linda and Olivia back, and then we're going to close with one song, and then you guys will be dismissed.
I have one.
Oh, sorry, one more question. Well, the honk, I didn't know y'all were going to get out of your cars. Like, so this is me. I thought you'd want to stay in your car where there's AC. But everyone wanted to come out and sit in the shade, which I'm okay for. But if you really want, I can be like, honk, honk, honk. There you go.
I shared with David earlier while we were off to the side, and I feel it's a good thing for us to hear together this morning that our Wesleyan church was started very much in a situation like this. John Wesley first preached outside to those who were going to work early in the morning, and so it's very familiar to the Wesleyan church for us to be in an outdoor service like this. So let us join in worship for our last song together. It's a familiar one, I hope, to you.
Saved a wretch.
I want to thank each and every one of you for being here. I did just have a reminder. If any of you, because you have personal tithing envelopes, did bring tithes with you, I can collect them and then give them to Linda, just so there is limited contact between people. But if you do want to turn that in or give tithes or offerings, we will start having a way on the 19th, other than online and the various ways we have been having tithes and offerings. For those of you who are interested, I do have the copies, the hard copies of the spending plan that I can give to you. But I pray that this week and the 12th, we're able to worship together online, that we're able to worship in spirit, God's spirit which dwells in us, and that on the 19th we will be able to celebrate again in person, online together, and that we will be able to once again have that joy of the gathering of believers. I pray that God will be with you and that you will go in his peace. God bless.
I need to figure out how to...